Hello everyone, my name is Ayer Risalem. Today I will show you the way of collecting and generating coordinate point data from Google Earth. Generally, there are a lot of mechanisms to collect the coordinate point data. Such mechanisms are can be handy GPS or we can also collect by using the application, which can be downloaded in our Android. Watershed having different features, for example, from the watershed having hillside and mountain, it may be difficult to collect the required data. So to collect bulk data, we can use the Google Earth as an alternative. So today we will see the way of generating point data from Google Earth. So we can go to Google Earth. Here, after opening the Google Earth, we can scroll up and down, left and right, up to getting our area of interest. So after getting our area of interest, we can directly go to add path. Here we can rename the path as point, for example, and we can change the color and style of our path, and we can also convert the measurement of the path into meter. Then after doing this, we can directly go to the area of our interest that we want to collect the point data. For example, if our area of interest is this, we can go here and we can do some irregular patterns, seems like this. This point data may be important for doing contour map, for example, and it can also be used as an input for generating DEM. So after doing this irregular shape, we can directly go back to the path and we can click OK. So here is the area of our interest that we want to collect the point data. So after doing this, we can directly right click on this and save place as point, for example, and yes, so we can minimize this, and here the required thing for doing this is the TCX converter. So for whom see this video should have the TCX converter, which can be downloaded from the web. So TCX, this is a simple portable software which can be downloaded from the web and can be easily installed in our desktop. So after doing this, we can open and click on this, find the file, the KML file that we saved before from the Google Earth, and open. Here is the latitude, longitude, and altitude, and other informations. The latitude and longitude are loaded simply, but the altitude is valued with zero. So to load the altitude, we need to go to track and update. So this process needs an active internet connection. So we need to have an internet connection to do this. So yes, here the process is going on now. It may take a while, so we need to wait up to the the accomplishment of the process. Now the altitude or the elevation data can be loaded by using web. So the altitude is filled seems like this. So after having this, we can save the output data in different forms. Can be saved in GPS format or in CSV. So for now we can save as CSV, and here we can click on save. Press yes to use semicolon as cell separator, not to use comma as cell separator. So we need to use comma rather than semicolon. So no. So now we can save our coordinate point data in desktop. Here we can open the point data. Here is the point data that we can generate from the Google Earth. So we can delete the unwanted data or the unwanted information. Delete. Here is the latitude, longitude, and altitude data. So we can save it. Save as point. Yes. Save. So we can exit from here. So to check the point in ArcMap, the point data in the ArcMap, we can open the ArcMap and import those collector point data, and we can do further synthesis by using those collector point data. So the ArcMap is on opening. Now the ArcMap window is opened. So what is next is go to file, add data, add XY data, and find the point data that we saved. So here we can go to desktop and find the control exercise in the point X data. So add. Here, the only thing that we want to change is altitude. Then we can project our coordinate point system. So now, UTM, Northern Hemisphere, and Zone 37. So now we can project the coordinate system and can click OK. Then OK, and finally OK. So this is the point data that we can generate from the Google Earth, and we can convert to chef file. So to do this, we can right click on this and go to data, export data, and save. Yes, we can remove the primary ones. And here is the chef file that we can generate from point data. So after having this chef file, we can do any other synthesis by using this point data. For example, you can do slope map, we can do DEM map, and we can do another contour map by using those point data. So if we want to check this point data back to Google Earth, we can go to conversion tool and to KML, layer to KML, and here the layer is the shapefile, and here we can change the save as type to point simply, and we can save. I mean invalid file type. So layer to KML point you can rename as E, then okay. The layer to KML process is on the way. So after accomplishing this process, we can go back to Google Earth and import the KML file to check the point data which are collected from the Google Earth before.